Okay, for the foreign sharing, our guest presenter, Priscilla, who is the senior QA engineer in Millennium IT Services. Hello, Priscilla.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, how's your day?
Thank you so much. Just a minute. You can see my screen, right? Okay.
Yes. Okay, it's your time right now. You show us what is the test data 101 for the APIs.
Yeah, thank you. So to start off with, we know test data is being one of the underutilized or underspoken topic regarding the APIs. So what we feel is when we are really started to test APIs, we should make sure that the test data has several combinations, and we need to have a few checks over the test data, which is more important. So here, there is no problem in going back and having to learning the basics, right? Of course, basics is important every time. So we will just take a break and just learn the basics, like how the test data has been evolved and what are the basic things you should keep in your mind when you're picking your test data and how that is going to impact the test data for your APIs, because that is in turn is going to help to test your APIs in a better way, right? So we just think about it and we'll just have a talk today on that. So this is all about me. So I work as a senior QA engineer for Millennium IT Services Malaysia, and these are my social handles. You can find me here, and I'm an active Postman community member, and I'm a Postman Supernova, and which is the current ambassador program which Postman offers. And I love to talk about Postman in all the forums, and I'm trying to educate as many as testers for Postman and APIs. So this is what I do. And for today's agenda, so this is what we have for today. And so first we'll, as I said earlier, we'll go back to the basics. We'll just get to see what is the test data, and we'll get to know the basics, like why test data has been so much important. And we have some traditional approaches for test data, like how we were doing all these times. And we will see some other applications where we are using, and some tips and tools and tricks, like what I'm using for testing my APIs in a better way using the data-driven approach. So therein comes about a little bit tricks in Postman, and we are using a tool which is Mockeroo. So I'll just do a little bit demo in that tool as well today. So this is a brainstorming session. So this test data knowledge is just required only for testers. So can you just think a bit detailed about it? So of course, this is not just for the testers. I believe even the developers or the BAs, they should have a basic knowledge, how the test data has been picked, and that how the testing has been done for all the systems, right? So this knowledge is very basic, and it's better to have. So how are we picking the test data? Of course, we know that is majorly for testing purpose, right? So we are going to do that. So how do we usually pick that data? We'll be having certain combinations where it's going to be a valid or invalid or a blank data. So these are the major three types of test data, which we are usually using everywhere. So valid is something of course, something which is totally valid for that field or that valid for that attribute, any valid value which it could take. And invalid is something of course, which is wherein this field is specifying about the number data type and you are trying to provide a string. So that kind of data is going to be an invalid data type. And blank is nothing but handling the null. So now we'll just think, we know what is test data. So why test data is so important? Because we know when you're trying to break or when you're trying to really test a system exhaustively, most of the flaws and most of the defects come in with the inadequate test data, missing to think about the combinations or missing to think what will happen in production. this kind of data, when it hits in production or real time, how does the system is able to behave? Is the system is able to behave and respond correctly? So these things we are totally missing in times, right? So if you are testing with an inadequate data, that is completely useless. So of course, when you are picking your test data, you have to be like more cautious, because this term as such it's been totally not spoken prevalent, and people are not giving so much importance to test data. And finally, when something blows up, they'll come back and they'll get to know, when doing the RCA, they'll come to know like this kind of data is being messed up. So the situation is very good today, right? So of course, what you're missing is like, if you have given some importance to test data in your test data phase itself, or during your test design phase, of course, you would have definitely caught that bug a bit earlier, and the mess has been totally avoided. So just make sure that the test data is a very important topic, and just try to spend some time for picking your test data every time. And talking about the traditional approaches, there are some traditional approaches wherein like these are the traditional approaches which we use to create the test data. So how we do, it's like a dummy test data, like where it's going to be AA, BB, CC, it's all going to be dummy test data. And sometimes we'll be just mocking the test data, like whatever explicit data which we want to have, say instead of the original name, we'll be mocking with another valid first name or last name. So that is how we'll be mocking the test data. And the third category is like anonymized data, like wherein it is going to be a de-identified data. You have a primary record in your table, and just you're masking that data so that it will not be disturbing, like it will not reveal the identity of the user as such. So in that way, you're going to mock that data where it becomes an anonymized data. You're not able to identify that record as a primary record. So say, for example, we'll swap the names, or we'll try to mask the important fields like your credit card number, your account number, all those fields will be done. And data subset, that is a fourth category. What is that is all about is like, there are some fields, because of course finance is so much confidential. So there are some fields wherein like the data is not too much confidential. So of course the production data can be used for testing, right? In that case, a subset of data, the production data, is directly used for your testing purposes. So that category is a fourth category, data subset. So these are the four major approaches which has been generally used to create your test data. And talking about the major applications, we know everywhere we are like started using this data. It can be for your testing purposes, to test your environments or to test your APIs. You can do that for your debugging purposes, or it can be for the DevOps purposes, we know. And most of the cases, it will be for the tool demo. You need a valid good test data to have a good tool demo, right? And also you should have invalid test data or during your demo as well. And for machine learning, of course, we know machine learning is mostly running towards the multiple combinations of lessons being taught to that machine, right? So of course we need more lots and lots of flavors of test data over there. So these are the major applications of test data. And talking about like what is test data management, okay, so this is like, okay, now I did my research, I did my analysis, and so based on the traditional approaches and all those modern approaches, like we are preparing the test data, and we are just keeping it in shelf. Is that it all? No. Like you should be very cautious, and you should have the process of maintaining and managing the test data. It is just not a one-time activity. You should ensure that if this test data, the process or the tool which you have in place is sufficient enough to cover the bugs, or it is sufficient enough to test your APIs. You should make sure that, right? So it is a continuous process, I would say. So test data is not just a one-day process or just a phase process. It's a continuous process. So that is why you would have seen in many, many companies right now, like the test data is really getting more of importance, and they especially have a team for test data management as well. So this team is so much expertise in all those test data, and they play with many set of tools to give the teams like whatever test data which they need. So try to import, like have a revisit whenever you have a different bug based on your test data miss or something. Try to revisit your technique, revisit your tool, and make sure that you are able to cover those sort of combinations in the future. So I would say like test data management is like continuous process, and you should be able to do that. And talking about the testata and alopecia, so we know for the quite long time, we gave so much importance for creating all those different sort of data for your front ends, and we can test all those things, right? So it is the same for APIs. So we shouldn't miss out that part, because even in the for the few months, I'm seeing this part like, okay, we are testing the APIs extensively, but we missed to check few other data combinations. And what in turn has happened is, like, of course, then when it goes to a front end team, or when it goes to a third party team who's doing a front end testing, of course, it's been caught over there. So what it happens, we know, why do we do the API testing? Of course, to have the, to catch the bugs earlier, and it's going to save your cost, right? So in that case, why I'm stressing this point is, like, make sure to invest some time when you're doing your test for APIs. Make sure to invest some time to dig in analysis and do an analysis, and to come up with a better test data solution, which is going to test your APIs efficiently. So it's the same way. So how the front end is having, it's the same way your API is also having an impact on your test data. So make sure that you're investing a very good time for creating an approach for your APIs for test data as well. And so here I would like to show something for you. So we predominantly use Postman for our testing, right? So like, we don't usually go with the hard-coded values or something. So we have a beautiful concept which is called dynamic variables in Postman, wherein, like, you have the option, like, to use the dynamic variables, wherein every time, for every single hit to your server, it will be picking a dynamic variable, wherein you have the multiple combinations of data that will help you to test and uncover few really bugs, right? So I just show you a demo right here. So if you take this, so this is how it works, like, using the Faker.js, you can directly use all those dynamic variables in Postman. You just need to enter your dollar symbol like this, and whenever you are doing this dollar symbol, right, it will show you the default dynamic variable objects which is already stored in Postman. So say, like, for example, for every hit, I would like to have a different a first name or last name. I should have an option. So say, like, if I have a random first name option, and for every, and this is like a demo endpoint, like, wherein this is just echo, like, whatever I'm trying to post here to the server. So if I'm just clicking save and send, right, you'll be able to see here. So for every hit and send, it is able to create a fresh set of test data, which is going to be a new data for me. So this will be useful when you're trying to create a bulk data or something. Even so, it'll be just because for every hit, it is going to make your test data unique, right? So you'll be getting a different name. So this is the inbuilt function which Postman offers. But in case, like, where there is an option, some users will have the different locales or localization, right? So based on their localization, they will be testing their APIs in a different country or a different country text as such. So there is an option like, wherein you can manually inject the Faker.js library. So what I'm going to do is, like, in my prerequisite script, I'll be manually injecting my Faker.js script, wherein I have the option, to update my locale as such. So wherein, like, if I would need just the French names, I just update this locale, and all these locale values you can see in the Faker.js documentation page. And I'm just going to hit send. And make sure that for here, I have used the variables like name and address. So I should make sure that the same variable names have been placed inside my body. Hit save and send. So if you see, I'm able to see a French name and a French address. So it's the same way, like, default, if you're planning to use a default dynamic libraries in Postman, like, that variables will be in English. And if you want to, like, rewrite or overload it also, you can do it using this code snippet. And what you can do is, like, it will definitely be for Ukrainian text also. If you just update this locale and if you just hit a send, you'll be getting a different text. So this will be helpful for your localization as well, and it will help you to really save a lot of time. So this is one idea which you can use it or there is another thing wherein like you have the option, we use this tool called Mockeroo, so which comes in place like wherein you have a specific set of requirements. Let's say like you have a very different schema, a unique schema based on your client requirements, and you have to work on that for for every hit you have to get a different set of test data, and there is like a lot of customizations. We would say like this tool is a good option, like you can go for that, and this tool can create you bulk data, and we have a lot of formats also, like where you can download, and there is no programming knowledge required for this tool. I will just give you a small demo about this tool. So this is how it will look like. So once you open, this is a basic schema which the tool as such will show you in the first page. So what it is going to do is like herein they have the inbuilt options for all those types, for ID and all, they have the unique row numbers, and for first name also, if you just hit and see, they have a lot of first name options. Like if you want the European names also, you have the option to create a specific European names as well. So once you click on and you just edit all these things, right? So say for example, if I would just need all these fields, and this is going to be my schema every time, and you can just even edit your rows also here. So say like I would just need a 5 rows and I would need as a JSON, you have the option to preview our data. So you can see, so every run, like you will get a very good test data, which is so customized for you. So for example, this is another case. You can have, you can write your formulas as well here. So wherein like they use the Ruby code to write extensive formulas here. Say for example, if you add the symbol before the field name, it means to say like this fields are to be used for the formula, which is going to be calculated later. So say for example, I need an email. I just don't want any dynamic junk email. I have a customization. I need a perfect first name and last name, and I need a specific domain, I would say. So you can use this sort of formula here. So I'm just concatenating my first username and last name. So this first name is going to generate a random first name for me, and this is going to generate a random last name for me, and finally I'm just going to concatenate both of them, and this is going to be my domain name. So if you see, I've just given 20 rows here, and I have the option to change, like you can have as a CSV, JSON, like we have multiple options here. So say like I have just given 5 rows, and I'm just clicking a preview of this data. Sorry, just a minute. So if you just give a preview, maybe I'll just show you another schema. So like this, you can just concatenate the data, and you can just click on your preview, and you will be getting your specific test data, like whatever which you want to get also. So in this case, and what you can do, so after getting this, after saving your schema, you have an option to save your schema, wherein like say if your schema is too big and too extensive and too specific based on your project, you can update your schema, and you can share the schema also to your teammates, wherein like they don't want to work on the schema specifically. So say for example, after this I have the option to copy my curl, and I can just paste in here in Postman, and I can just click save. So what is the purpose of this? It's like, so every, for example, for every run, if I would need a specific test data inside the Postman, because I have already changed my request based on my testing purposes. So in that case, for every hit, if I would need a specific test data, like I can change this request inside my existing request. Say for example, if I can just update my count. So for every count, I would just need one count of data, a fresh test data, which I have configured in that way. And this data, if it has to be used in my previous request or for my post request, I can save it as a variable, and I can just carry forward to the future request as well. So this is like on the fly, you can have your customized test data and it will try to fulfill your project needs or based on your client needs. You can customize it and it's not just bulk data, and you can generally have your all your flavors being included in that also. So this is about this tool. So the final takeaway is of course, we do have a lot of test data approaches coming up every day, and we do it because in generally, most of the projects, you'll get your mocked up test data from your client directly where it is as a CSV or JSON. You can directly feed that to your APIs and test it. But in some cases, wherein you have to do your analysis, make sure that you're spending some time for your test data process, because that definitely saves a lot of time in future. So make sure you're spending a good time, and that will definitely help you to uncover a few of the very important bugs, because we have personally felt that when we are testing our APIs. So this is my take on it. So,
okay, there is a question from the stage chat. Can you show us how to add some predefined data set for the dynamic variable in the mocker room? How to add the data set and how to manage it?
Okay. How to add
data
set is usually once you log in, right? You will definitely first have this plan schema. So else, if you want to create a schema, you can just create on this create schema. So wherein this is going to be the field name which I want to look at in my JSV or CSV, and this is we have a lot of options, what type of value has to be generated or to be showcased for that field. So here I have lots of options based on that. So if you need an URL or if you need a any kind of random text and all, so you can just select it. Say for example, here it is as a row number will give you a unique number for every rank, and my next attribute name is going to be first name. So here if you type on this first type, right, so it's going to be for first name. So for example, if I need a European first name, I'm just selecting my first name as European, and this is my attribute name, and I need a last name. I think last name has just only one category, so it's just the last name, and I don't need an email address. Say for example, I just need an IP address, and which is going to be, you can based on say for example, if you need a valid IP address, you have this kind of combinations wherein you can pick it. Say for example, if I need this report, I can just select it. So these are my field names, and these are the types of values which has to be populated for that field. And here I can select the number of rows which I wanted to do. So here, and if I need to see it as a CSV or if I need all the types, if it has to be an array or if it can include the null values, you can check and uncheck this also. Say if, for example, if I need that to be an array, and if I preview this, it will look like this. And if I don't need that to be an array, you can just see all those values like this. And now what I will be doing is I have created my schema, right? So I have to just save the schema. So my schema will be saved. So what are the data combinations which I wanted and what are the field names which I wanted? It will be already saved in the schema. So does this answer, Derek?
Okay, I think the time is almost up for this session. Okay, thanks, Priscilla, to share some testing skills or testing tools with us for us to know more about the testing process. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Thank you.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you so much for your time. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for having me. Thank you, guys. Bye.
Okay. Have a nice.